Yeah.
You can't even stop the video.
Come on. Yeah. Hitting up the gym, trying to get top, bigger than Arnie, blacker than Cole. I ain't got time for haters like yo. Run up on me, man, and you're gonna take a fall. Flying so high, like zero gravity. Sicker than yo with your sexual depravity.
Yo!
Morning guys, Brad Thompson here from brandthompson.co.uk and we are currently on my last day of carb depletion. Well, for my practice photo shoot. Yeah, basically what I'm going to be doing is my photo shoot's a week's time on Saturday, but I'm going to practice this week like the carb depletion and carb loading and like manipulate my sodium and water and that. So. Yeah, so I'm going to do carb depletion up until the end of today, along with some glycogen depletion workout that I've been doing. I'll show you guys anyway, I'll get some footage of that. And yeah, so my diet literally consists of, I've kind of gone ketogenic, I guess. So it's just fat, so I've decreased my carbs to like below 10%, and my fats have gone up to 60 or something like that. So. As you can tell, I'm not. Well, I don't look great. I feel absolutely awful. And I decided, well, I'm supposed to be drinking 9 litres of water a day. And for some silly reason, I decided to down like 2 litres before bed last night because I realised I'm drunk enough. I was up for like a record number of times last night. I'm gonna pee, I think, like literally like 11 to 15 times. So it was absolutely horrible. Just couldn't sleep either. But in the end, I got quite a bit of sleep, to be fair, about 9 hours. So, still not feeling fresh, feeling a bit ill. Just gonna go make my dinner. God, I'm not with it. My breakfast. In a bit.
Things tend to happen. There's one great truth on this planet. Whoever you are, or whatever it is that you do, when you.
Yo, guys, in the gym now. I'm gonna do a leg and shoulder kind of circuit just to deplete the rest of glycogen that's in my muscles before carbing up tomorrow. Here with George. Keep you guys posted.
I can't find my way back to you till you make amends with the demons you've been through. And I can't regret leaving you alone until you find your way back home.
My leg circuit done. Moving on to shoulders now. I haven't done a lot for legs because it's my last kind of day of working out and then taking 3 days off to carb load, not really do much, look a bit full up. That's my practice sort of shit, then we start the carb depletion all over again next week. So yeah, let's go through my shoulder circuit. Oh, by the way, I'll put the actual workout in, well, I'll put a link to the actual workout, which will be on my site in the description. So head over there, check that out. Anyway, shoulders.
don't let me drown. Don't let me drown. Don't let me drown. Find your way back home.
So yeah, last workout for 3 days, done now. As I said, I'll put that up on my site, so head over there, check it out, give the workout a go. Start my carb loading tomorrow, so it feels like Christmas, so looking forward to that. But just quickly gonna head over to the cafe at college, try and get some food there, see if they've got anything without any carbs. Probably end up getting a salad. Probably end up getting a salad. So yeah, good workout in general.
I guarantee your salad's got croutons in it.
Eh? I have to pick up the croutons. These must, guys, needs must.
Alright,
well anyway, I'll speak to you guys later on. Yeah. Alright guys, Brandon Thompson here. We're going to do a quick Q&A with my main man, George Clugston.
Hey guys.
Alright, so let's start with the first question. Let's just start off by saying I'm getting a lot of emails. On my Facebook and through Facebook and emails. One of which, a massive one from like 8 different people, was spot reduction. So George, what do you think of spot reduction?
I think spot reduction is a myth.
Yeah.
Most people know that abs aren't made by doing ab work, they're made in the kitchen.
Yeah, I mean, so. You know, your diet is probably one of your most important things, isn't it? I'd say 75%, 80% of the work is diet. I mean, some people go through these like crazy kind of like diets. I'm not a massive fan of ketogenic, but I mean, you're a fan of ketogenic.
Yeah, I like ketogenic. I think it works for what I want to do.
I mean, it's not going to work for everyone, but as long as you're in a calorie deficit, it's like 300 calories below your maintenance level, you're going to be losing weight anyway at a steady pace, like a pound per week, maybe a pound and a half per week. The main thing when getting toned up is just kind of like, just give yourself time. I mean, it's not going to happen overnight. Make sure your calories are right.
Yeah, so if you're watching this, Tom, you know who you are.
Yeah.
You're not going to get abs by doing ab work, you're going to get abs by eating right exercise.
Exactly, you can't expect to go out
cardio,
on the piss, eat crap, and expect to get abs. It's not going to happen. What's your take on cardio when cutting them? You massive.
I hate cardio.
Yeah, no, I don't think anyone likes cardio.
You can't do it, don't you?
But yeah, exactly. I mean, there's a massive kind of like, well, not argument, but kind of topic of whether high intensity interval training or steady pace cardio is better, and whether to do it fasted or after your workout. I mean, I think it's just a kind of a matter of trial and error, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, we haven't even figured out yet.
Yeah, exactly.
We try everything.
Yeah, I mean,
one day you might want to do. Steady cardio, next day I might want to do sprints, or fast-paced cardio, or whatever. So.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, when we cut last time, we were doing what, steady pace?
Steady cardio. Well, we started on steady pace and then sort of adapted it.
Yeah, we kind of like switched up a little bit, because I think...
But also the advice of our coach.
Yeah, we're a strength and conditioning coach when we used to play rugby. Yeah.
Sprints
instead. Yeah, I mean, as long as you're doing it at a point where, you know, you've used up the glycogen in your muscle stores, and, you know, you're then hitting those fat stores and burning the fat instead of obviously using up your glycogen, then you're not really going to achieve what you want to achieve, whereas as in burning fat. For me, I prefer doing it after my workout, I'm not going to lie, and I prefer high-intensity interval training.
So, yeah, I think I'm more of a fan of fasting cardio.
Yeah, no, you did like that.
Well, I think that was a combination of you got me up in the morning and got me something to do.
Yeah, exactly.
I was lying in bed all day, came into college in the morning at 7 a.m, did a bit of cardio, and then I could just sort of chill out for a bit, get some food.
Yeah. Alright. Okay, so the next question was bulking. dirty bulk or clean bulk? What's your take on this?
Clean bulk all the way. Yeah. Only wholesome sugar-filled foods like
flapjacks. I
tried a clean bulk for a while. Couple of blocks, relatively clean. Couple of months of it, and it's too tedious.
Yeah.
You need to mix up a bit. I think also depends on what you're trying to achieve as well. Because yeah, I mean, Brandon, you're looking to do get a fitness model sort of shape. You're not worried about putting on too much size.
Yeah, exactly.
And you're looking to do like a steady year-long bulk. Whereas what I was hoping to do was do a shorter bulk, pack on quite a lot of muscle mass, not really worry about what fat I was putting on, and then cut when the time came.
Yeah.
Because I did it last time. I went from being fat last time after a very dirty couple of years of bulking.
Yeah, no, it was bad.
And I managed to lose all my fat within, 4 months?
Yeah, I mean, guys, it's all about, especially when you're beginning, trial and error. I know I keep saying this, but you're not really going to know something until you've tried it. And, you know, I've done both. I did I started off as a steady bulk, like 2 years ago when I first begun, at 16 years old. Ended up at 18 at, like...
Yeah, I quickly changed.
Oh, yeah, 103 pounds, dirty bulk. 103 kilos.
You fat bastard.
Yeah, 103 pounds. What's that in pounds? That's like, what, 230 pounds I was. So I'm like 170 now. So I've lost a hell of a lot of weight. But no, I was fat, and dirty bulk didn't really work for me. I put on some size, but I just felt horrible. I felt fat, I felt lazy, unhealthy. But whereas dirty bulking seems alright for you, you don't seem to put that much fat on. With a dirty
bulk. Well, it depends how long. If I did the bulk I'm doing now for a year, then I would get very fat.
Mm. Yeah, exactly. And also time frame comes into it. Yeah. I mean, you're looking to what?
I'm looking to rush it.
Yeah, he's doing like an aggressive bulk, so.
I'm getting sick of bulking at the moment, to be honest.
Yeah.
So I'm giving myself up until the end of, beginning of January, maybe a little bit into January before I start cutting again. So that'll be three months.
Nah.
3 months bulk.
So yeah, exactly.
If you give yourself that short of time, you need to do an aggressive bulk.
Yeah, but you know, another main point, even when bulking, it's the exact same as cutting. Count your macros. It's pretty important. I mean, we're not all great at doing it. I'm not the best at doing it. There's a lot of guys out there that are a lot better counting their macros than I. Yeah, exactly. But I would really suggest, even because it might not be the case that you're eating too much. It may be the case you're eating too little for your bulk. So count macros. And kind of figure out what your time frame is, what you want to achieve, where you want to be.
Maybe sometimes it's not such an issue to count your macros specifically, but just keep track of your calories.
Yeah, keep calories.
Make sure your calories are above what they need to be.
Yeah, but then you want to make sure you're hitting the right amount of...
Yeah.
Because obviously you don't want to be hitting like 100 grams of protein and...
No, but I mean, if you're doing what I'm doing and doing a dirty bulk, I know... without working out, just from what I'm eating, I'm going to be filling my protein, I'm going to be filling my carbohydrate, I'm going to be filling my fat with enough.
Yeah.
So as long as I'm eating enough food and getting over the calories that I need, I know that I'll be getting my macros. But you should keep your macros. Make sure that you are.
Yeah, no.
So don't just eat bread all day and hope that that's going to
be... I hope you're going to get big, yeah. No, make sure you're getting the right amounts. Have a look about. I mean, I'll put some articles on my site and on my Facebook as well. Just helping you guys, you know, understand. I got a new article up on my site, so head over there, I'll put the link in the description, check that out. It's just understanding your macros, help you count them and stuff like that, so I'll hopefully make it easy for you guys. And that's pretty much it for the Q&A type thing. But if you guys want to send us any more questions, I'll get back to you in the next vlog. And I'm turning it up. Yeah, so questions like in the comments, you can email me. I'll put the email in the description along with my Facebook and everything else, and
Minor George's Thompson Fitness, which is our Instagram page. Hit us up on Instagram.
Put a link in the video.
Hey?
You've got a link in the description.
Yeah, I'll put that in the description below. Alright guys, see you later. Alright guys, just before I end the video, just want to say a massive thank you to everyone that supported me so far. Got loads of messages on Facebook, by email, even just like people text me, like friends text me and stuff. So, just want to say a massive thank you to everyone so far. Just keep liking, sharing, subscribing. That would do me a massive favour. Keep doing it. Check out my website, which is which just gone up last week. I'll put the link in the description. You know what to do, guys. Like, follow on Facebook, and subscribe on YouTube. See you later, guys.